Jason, thank you. One of those games out west will never let you down. Except for Colorado State right now. Welcome to the American Bank Center in Corpus Christi, Texas. John Grady and Bob Wenzel, we are just underway. This is the semifinal round of the Corpus Christi Coastal Classic. The winner will advance to the title game tomorrow night. Bradley really stepping up in class, but you know what, Bob? So is TCU. This is going to be their toughest opponent despite their dominant 5-0 start. Here's what you missed.
And so far, it's 4-4. You haven't missed a lot if you're just tuning in right now. Game summary. Early in the game, Bradley gets off, the point guard. Bell hits one early, and then the drive to the basket right here. Solid movement on the interior. They are a big, big team. TCU, of course, they are solid going to the basket right there. Trey Ziegler is a power guard who transferred in. His dad was a coach at Central Michigan, and he went there, then Pitt. And this is what it looks like so far.
We'll give you all a chance to catch up with your scorecards. TCU is 5-0, and they haven't just been beating teams. They have been beating teams up. And, yes, the schedule can be easy early on, but, hey, that you play the teams in front of you, and they are doing what good teams do, which is beating them up early. They're 10th in the nation in scoring differential.
Well, you know, they're 0 for the league last year, 0-18 in the Big 12. So what would you do? You would schedule down. Obviously, that's what you want to try to do to build some confidence in your team. Now, they have an influx of guys that have come in, namely Trey Ziegler and Chris Washburn. Those are guys who sat out and now can play for them. So that's a big, big addition for TCU, and they're off to a good start building confidence.
Trent Johnson said he's just happy to be back coaching again this year. And when you ask him what he means by that, why weren't you coaching last year? He said, I wasn't coaching. I was praying.
Well, they have more talent right now. And, of course, the Big 12, a very, very tough conference. Bradley used to winning in the Missouri Valley, but Wichita State has dominated that conference as of late. So they're going to hit their stride here. Lost 2 and then 1-2. Auston Barnes is a big addition, number 4, back in the game. And helps their defense. 8-15.
Three-point play for Trey Ziegler is what has given TCU their first lead. And here is the aforementioned Auston Barnes. Ian Anderson, who might end up being the star of this tournament. He's getting all the attention. Number 5 for TCU, has it now. Senior point guard. He has never gotten to play with players this talented around him.
He's scoring less this year than he did last year. 17 a game last year, 14. That's because the team is better. Second leading returning scorer in the Big 12 Conference behind Juwan Staten of West Virginia. This kid's got game.
Washburn, the lefty. Backs it in.
Should not count. We're going to count anyway, Sean, but it should not count. Got to call that, man.
Replication was that was not his intent. Quick hands, Ziegler. Coach's son. Leads the odd man break. Paris will go to the line.
TCU on the move. When you get the double team, you hit it. Pick and pop. Washburn makes that lefty off the glass. He should be smiling on the retreat on that one. Harris going to the free throw line. Sorry, Sean.
He's the first recruit for Trent Johnson in this sophomore class. Shepard is a sophomore. Washburn is a sophomore. Kenrich Williams, who's going to come off the bench, is a sophomore, which means they got a few years to get their act together, and they're already playing very well together as a front court because these are high basketball IQ players.
Yeah. Harris last year played solid, 8 points a game. Daryl Bell, the point guard, junior, 6'1", 190.
Warren Jones back up in the big game on Tuesday night. His drive is not fruitful, but on the offensive rebound, Xavier Taylor will get fouled and will go to the line. Jim Ford's already used a bunch of guys here at the start.
Jones in traffic, ain't going to happen right there. But the follow, excellent, going after it. Shooting two for the Razor, 22, Xavier Taylor.
Xavier Taylor won a state title playing with Josh Cunningham, who's the highly touted 18-year-old true freshman who started for Bradley, and we'll see plenty of him as the night moves along.
I like this guy, number 21, Hudson Price.
Maybe he looks a little familiar when you get a look at him. Look close, everybody. Maybe you'll see a face for the record.
The son of Mark, the great player at Georgia Tech and longtime NBA star. I think you do the Celtics. Isn't Price the leading free throw shooter in the history of the league?
Fields turned away. He and Steve Nash. Nash's percentage points, hundreds of thousands of points, you know, ahead of him. Xavier Taylor misses in close, and a good job by Kenrich Williams not to foul. But Steve Nash and Mark Price, the only players ever to shoot over 90%. He and Anderson creating, but couldn't stop himself, and it's Cadero Bell who draws the charge.
We're going to see a lot more charges this year. You know, they changed the rule back. Right here, help side defender is outside the arc. Nice play. Good team defense by the Braves on that one. Trent doesn't like the call. However, he's not wearing a striped shirt, so he gets no vote.
He's going holiday casual. I like it.
Jones is a volume shooter. Number two with the ball. Second leading scorer on the team comes off the bench.
Darryl Bell had a crazy buzzer beater at halftime in their win on Tuesday night. Shooters love when that shot clock winds down. Barnes to the line. And you can see what a difference he makes. Kenrich Williams is the one call for the foul.
Post up. Turn toward the baseline. The pump fake gets his man to lean. As a result, he gets his opportunity at the free throw line. A lot of guys go up immediately, and that's sometimes a mistake.
High school legend from the state of Ohio, Geno Ford, in his fourth year. He's talked about practice distractions for this team, not having his entire team, including Auston Barnes, with him, off-the-court issues, nagging injuries, but they're getting closer to having their whole team back, which is what you need as you start to gear up towards league play.
They are missing Tremeek Sutherland, who's the junior college point guard who was supposed to start. He's with them on the trip, but not playing. You and I talked to him before the game. Soft-spoken, but very talented player. When they get him back, that's going to be a full compliment all over. In the meantime, Dell is going to have to play big minutes.
Speaking of talent, you just saw Josh Cunningham check into the game, number 21 in red. Amrick Fields at one, and this is going to be a very important player for TCU when they get into the Big 12. If he can stay healthy, this front court is very deep.
The drive, the dish, the help comes, and Amrick takes it in there strongly. He's been around for 5 years, 6'9", 220, inside-outside guy, knee problems, all kind of health situations.
TCU plus 13 on the glass through their first 5 wins.
Well, that's not going to happen in this game. We got some evenly matched interior players in this one. Nice defense, push them off the block.
Anderson shoots over it.
He is cold right now. Anderson used to shooting in big arenas in the Big 12 with his 17, 15,000 people. And this gym is pretty empty.
It's early, Pop.
Yeah.
Could be traffic. To Darryl Bell. Taylor create room for himself, but didn't get a good look. And it's Hudson Price with the rebound.
They want to push it. Price is a shooter. Price is a maker. Find him in transition. The shot is a little slow, but he had
to. Who Hudson's dad was, and most of them, with the exception of Chris Washburn, had no idea, so he just went to YouTube and said, you may want to check some of this out from the NBA All-Star game. And everybody turned to Hudson and said, wait, that was your dad? Whoa.
We can see here the guy with the ball, Bell, has not been out of the game. He averages 34 minutes per game, and that's a lot of minutes to log as the point guard. He's directing the team and also playing defense on Anderson. Need to keep an eye on his fatigue level.
Warren Jones for three.
He wants it, boy. He has never met a shot that he does not like. This kid is ready to shoot when he gets off the bus.
He's already taken 21 threes, and this is Bradley's fifth game. He's playing about 20 minutes off the bench.
And that's the most on the team.
Price on the drive. He and Kenrich Williams do not connect. Jones, he's calling his own number again. Cleaned up by Taylor. And Jones throws it away. Put him in a portion of the court he is not comfortable, and that's what's going to happen. Ziegler's third stop. after Central Michigan and Pittsburgh playing his senior year here. Kian Anderson is 0 for 4.
Yeah, he's not finding it. He's complaining to the official on the way back. Not a good sign. He's used to getting high number of shots and then going in. So far, not so much. He shoots 54% from three-point range. Hasn't been close.
Greer against Price finds Taylor.
Three guys for Trent Johnson at the scorer's table waiting to come in. Both coaches has you frequent substitutions except at the point guard position. Both guys have played the whole game, Anderson and Bell.
Kian Anderson's played 24 minutes a game, but that number will go way up as the competition level does.
Indeed. When they're way ahead, he uses different players, and they've been way ahead in all their games this year.
Ziegler comes to get it and likes that spot.
That's his range, you know, a little bit inside the three-point line is where he can make a living. And he's physical enough to do that.
He was a big recruit for his dad at Central Michigan. Turned down some bigger schools.
Guys on the floor are fatigued. There are now five players waiting at the scorer's table to come into the game. Make that six.
Busy early season schedule for pretty much all the teams here this weekend.
We watched practices yesterday and they did not go hard because of the fatigue factor.
Omari Greer draws Hudson Price in and he'll have free throws when we return. Trey Ziegler hopes he is found.
Well, Hudson Price
gets some early run.
Hudson Price is a shooter. He made his open three early and he also drove to the basket and dished. So, you know, not only does he have the genetic factor going with his dad being Mark Price, he also is a hard-working player. He's a freshman on this team. This is Omari Greer, leading scorer. You see his numbers. Has not been involved much in this game so far. 0 for 1, no points.
33 on opening night. First Bradley player to do that since Percy. This is both. And a good free throw shooter.
Anderson out of the game right now. Chauncey Collins is the point guard for TCU. Anderson 0 for 4, all from three-point range. He needs to sit and think about that a little bit.
Chauncey Collins, very interesting background for the freshman. Home school. You're playing an entirely different brand of high school basketball. You step back three. TCU point guards are now 0 for 5. We'll get Collins on that end quick, preventing a fast break for Cunningham.
When you say homeschooled, I immediately think of Tim Tebow, a great football player at Florida, and of course, Phenom.
Whatever happened to him, you almost never hear his name anywhere.
He's around. He's in our business now. Collins, a scorer, but has not had a lot of minutes this year so far, so this is new to him, number one defensively here in the white.
That's Auston Barnes. A stretch four. Shooting cold early.
You can tell he's a little bit nervous. They should put pressure on.
When Chauncey Collins has been in for TCU, generally speaking, through these first couple of weeks of the season, TCU has been up by 30.
Yeah, right.
Not only
exactly.
Is stepping up in competition, this is early in the game, and Trent Johnson saying, all right, kid. And he was very clear. Trent Johnson was very interested to see how his team responded. And he was saying to us, hey, you know, they think they're pretty good, which is what you want at 5-0. But he knows this weekend, at some point, they're going to get punched in the mouth, and he's curious to see how they respond.
It's a delicate balance when you're dealing with younger players and developing their confidence and still And Chauncey is a situation like that. If I'm Geno Ford, I'm going to go after him and pressure him as much as I can. Bell is a very good defensive player, the point guard from Bradley, number zero. It would be wise for him to get after Collins a little bit to see if he can get some turnovers.
Largest lead for TCU. What a fall it has been in Fort Worth. It opened some eyes yesterday. What margin of victory. Cunningham going inside. That's good recognition that there was contact. And Barnes was fouled by Kenrich Williams. Kenrich Williams coming off the bench for Trent Johnson. This is a coach's dream. A young man says, you want to start me? Come off the bench, whatever you need, coach.
I don't know. When I was coaching, the guys didn't
anybody
say
ever,
whatever
anybody
I
ever
need.
Say that?
Actually, they do. There's a lot of unselfish players, right?
It's Kenrich Williams from Waco, New Mexico Junior College, a team that was very highly ranked among junior college teams last year. And Trent Johnson said he's been our best wing.
Yeah, and he didn't go to junior college for 2 years, so he was okay academically, so he only went 1 year, so he was only a sophomore. Well, Anderson's back in the game right now, and you can see there's full court pressure. Geno Ford saw what I was talking about, but unfortunately so did Trent Johnson, so he brought Anderson back in the game.
Keep in mind, Anderson missing all four of his threes. He was 12 of 22. Able to 50% shooting threes in the first 5 days.
Yeah. It'll be interesting to see if he comes back. I'm sure he will. He's the most experienced player in this game by far. 2-3 zone for the first time. Wise, since Anderson's not shooting well. Not a lot of outside shooting on this team. Good play by Geno Ford.
Ziegler knifes through it. The leg got taken off the rim by Cunningham. Athletic play. He lost sight of Washburn, who strips him. Parrish on the attack.
That's going to be a block.
And more free throws coming for Brandon Parrish. Warren Frog starting to outwork Bradley here, holding a 5-point lead. Stick around.
Yes, he's a very soft-spoken player. Junior college transfer, he was going to be the starting point guard on this team. And as a result, you know, he's from Toronto, excellent player. So as a result, Kadaro Bell is the starting point guard, averaging 34 minutes a game. When he comes back, he's got a hand injury. When he comes back, probably in the next couple of weeks, I think that's going to be a big plus for Bradley.
Hey, we'll get news on Trumeek on Monday that he will hopefully be able to take off that soft cast. And talking to him before the game, he just can't dribble with it. Which, for a point guard, I'm going to suggest.
Well, it hurts, he told us, and even when he tries to catch it, the ball, I mean, it's just too painful. And so he's not available right now.
TCU's largest lead has been 7.
Very aggressive game on the interior. Officials doing a good job of letting most of it go.
Barnes created his own shot there, but couldn't knock it down.
Just talking about it now, it's getting a little physical right now.
Mark Shepard and Mike Shaw.
Let's watch the scrum underneath the basket. Unusual, they double team the rebounder, so there's no outlet. I'm not sure who's going to get called for this foul. Shepard's going to get called for the foul. He doesn't understand it. He felt like he got taken down, and in the scramble for the loose ball, he gets the foul.
Second foul on Shepard, so he will come out. Has another chance to get untracked. A lot of excitement in Fort Worth about Kavar Shepard. Now, there was a ton of excitement about this guy, Mike Shaw, coming out of high school from De La Salle High School. He went to Illinois and played a couple years there and just could not get in the rotation. He was a top 75 recruit when he went to Illinois. Now he'll have a couple of years to finish up with Bradley.
Modest numbers. Part of the interior rotation of 4 and 5 men. Back to man-to-man defense on the part of Bradley. They went zone for a little bit.
Parrish has been active. Ian Anderson now pulls back and gets fouled on his way in. Shot's not going. Take it inside.
We have not seen three-point shooting as a factor for either team in this game, which is highly unusual in college basketball. Most times you're going to get three-point shooters in the game. It is a gigantic part of college basketball. A lot of teams have four players who can make threes. This afternoon, Butler picked way down in the Big East, made a bunch of threes to beat Georgetown. So the three-point shot, this guy is their normal guy there.
He's the primary reason TCU shooting 47% from the three.
Yeah, look at that right hand. 54% for him on the year so far, and he was good last year as well.
Gets them both. This is the largest lead for TCU. Andrew Parrish was a big part of that. Hudson Price returns.
Both of these teams physically play in the paint aggressively. You know, they have a lot of 6'8", 225-pound type guys in this game. And they both are playing aggressive man-to-man defense for the most part. So clean shots, not that available so far in the game.
When you watch Kean Anderson at the start of this year in these early games, there is an excitement that comes with a point guard who all of a sudden has a lot more clubs in his bag can use.
Yeah.
And he has started so strong because of that.
That means his numbers are going to go down in terms of scoring. But coming into this game, he had 20 assists and only 6 turnovers. So that speaks to the quality of the teammates that he now has. Last year, he had to do everything for this team. They only won 9 games, 9-22, 0-18 in the Big 12. I don't think it's going to be like that this year. 2-2-1. Try to trap at the 10-second line. Right there. Wise not to go across right there. They handle it well, and typically you go back into a 2-3 zone, which is what Bradley is doing right now.
Look at this. Ziegler at 6'5 is the smallest guy on the floor right now for TCU.
Yeah. They will try to get the interior passing going. Ooh, how about that rebound?
This is a very exciting young player, number 21, Josh Cunningham.
Yep. That's a big-time rebound right there. He's got hops. Body on body here.
Taylor can't finish. Washburn the rebound. Boy, that ball finds him. You notice that. When you watch TCU, Washburn is around the ball.
Washburn bodied him up so he couldn't jump.
Now Trey Ziegler getting a chance to run the show after the freshman Chauncey Collins had a little cameo midway through this first half.
Anderson getting rest while Bell has to stay out there.
Ziegler off the window, can't get it.
That was a contested shot. I'm impressed with the defenses of both of these teams. Very physical nature.
That's what Bradley did to Texas A&M Corpus Christi the other day. And you hold TCU without a bucket for 5 minutes. You're doing work.
I think part of the fact that Anderson is cold in this game changes the entire offensive system right here for TCU. They're used to him being hot, drawing attention, and getting other players involved. Not so much in this game when he's not playing well.
Second foul on Washburn. So now Washburn and Shepard on the bench with two. And this is exactly why TCU is going to need Amrick Fields to be healthy. They're going to need Link Cabajindi, the 7-foot freshman, to be able to give them some minutes, and guys like Chauncey Collins. It's going to get physical in that Big 12. This is the fun part of the season because those early games are done. You stepped up in class, away from home for the first time. Yeah, they were in these road uniforms for the first time.
But TCU is not even playing in their home arena this year because it's being a $59 million redo. So they're playing off campus at a public arena.
The first time they have not been able to get separation in the first half. Good look by Ziegler on the inside of Washburn who goes to the left hand to finish.
Ziegler's effectiveness has been with taking the ball into the paint. Washburn finds the seams very nicely. Take a look on the interior here. See how much banging is going to go on. Nice little cut there.
Nice idea for Cunningham, but he hit the rim instead of Auston Barnes. We're going to get this one on Taylor.
They had a perfect back screen set up. And it was going to be a lob dunk. TCU was not aware of it, but the pass was off. Take a look right here. Back screen on the weak side. No. This is Ziegler and Washburn, the penetration move. Those two connecting nicely. Physical players like it in the paint. You talked about this guy, and they are thrilled that he is able to get back in and give them some minutes.
He's only played 21 games the last 2 years as Amrick Fields after he was sixth man in the Mountain West. That's how long he's been at TCU. Sixth man in the Mountain West.
Came in 2010.
Bell draws the contact. Find a freshman out there. It's like a sharp smelling blood. Where's the freshman? I'm going at him.
Trent Johnson. Very, very experienced coach. His son is director of basketball operations at Texas A&M Corpus Christi, so it's running in the blood.
He's coached at LSU and Stanford and Nevada as an assistant. A lot of players have gone on to the NBA. Lopez twins, Collins, Mark Snyder, Marcus Thornton. His 250th win. As the head coach on Monday night, the first of four games TCU will play this week. Darryl Bell.
Look at the action on the interior. Man. Washburn and Shaw are banging.
Michael Williams getting a shot at the point down for TCU.
Pick and pop, not there. Good D. Notice the switch. Love the switch.
Good shot by Barnes, and Fields just goes down away.
Welcome back, Mr. Fields. TCU needs you. Boy, that adds a lot.
Largest lead now for TCU. Barnes over Washburn. One of those to fall.
Big rebound right there. Very, very nice. Ziegler's a power guard. Comfortable doing the dirty work, the blue collar type stuff.
TCU doing this without Kian Anderson. That's the impressive thing. They're getting the separation with Anderson on the bench.
Well, I think it's a wise move by Trent Johnson.
And the craziness of the transfers. Three players from the same team, all in the same tournament on the same weekend, not on the original team.
Yeah, and they're all good players and all contributing to their next school. And it happens a lot. And his son has been in three places, Central Michigan, Pittsburgh, and now here. We have guys leaving one school and playing at another school right away. Those circumstances arise. We have Matt Carlino, who plays at Marquette, had 38 points in his game. Started at UCLA and then went to BYU, now at Marquette. So we've got a lot of free agency in college basketball going on.
That's a good way of putting it. Largest lead now for TCU. Bradley has only made three shots in this first half and thought they would have trouble scoring. He thought correctly. Slashing, driving, but not finishing was Dante Thomas, another true freshman for Bradley. Didn't get the same attention as Josh Cunningham, but he's coming off a pretty good game starting for Cunningham on Tuesday night.
But part of the reason that they're not scoring is they're not getting any second shots on the interior. Big guys in the paint like Washburn there and the pass from Emmerich. Nice connection between those two post players. Take a look at this pass. He's doubled, bounce pass along the baseline. That is a thing of beauty. Fields to Washburn. Emmerich Fields gives them basketball IQ, as does Washburn. When those two are in together, I mean, good things happen.
And the payoff of that, they've only played 5 minutes together.
Yeah, interesting.
This is just the start. These are the infant minutes of Washburn and Fields playing together. Doesn't get the bounce on the free throw, but this is the largest lead for TCU.
And the reason they haven't played much together is that Amrick has been injured, and Washburn's in his first year.
Barnes has been trying. Can't get one to go. This time cleaning up his own miss. He'll go to the line.
Now, you see one of the problems right there with Fields and Washburn in. They're not as big with Fields in the game, and there's going to be some second shots. A
Auston Barnes makes a huge difference for Bradley. They didn't have in those first two games. They had a bad loss in the preseason. And then lost their first two games to Texas Arlington and Robert Morris. And they were getting a little restless in Peoria, but waiting the return of Sutherland and now having Barnes back, it's been a different team. And coming up at the half, Brett Stover, Al Abdelnaby, John Rothstein will catch you up on a busy day in college basketball, including all the highlights from today's top 25 action. Wisconsin leading that particular pack. Stay tuned for the guys. Best way to get your college basketball information, unless you have John Rothstein's number, you can just text him. He might be the best Twitter follow in college basketball, period.
He's the best. Follows everything.
Michael Williams, number two in the game at the point guard position right now. Third guy working at that spot.
Those 5 points for Bradley have come over the last 6 minutes. That's the separation again for TCU. Dominant first half team through the first 3 weeks of the season because of second chances.
This is going up.
Looking to reset. Harold Bell looks back to Geno Ford for the play call. Good job by Parrish going under the screen. TCU is so well coached. That's a bucket they needed from Xavier Taylor. You have a 6 minute scoring drought against a red hot TCU team. You go into the locker room down 5-6 points, you gladly take that.
Well, Trent Johnson wants to make it more than that, so that's why it's NCAA tournament, and they're going to play against a very athletic Mississippi State team.
Who is two-time A-10 coach of the year, and he is starting from scratch with his own players. They're fun to watch. You see a lot of different guys play in our second game tonight.
Over 400 wins for Jim Cruz. Williams, nice handle.
Parrish misses the three.
Not even close.
Bradley hit their first two shots in the first half. Since then, 2 for 15.
Wow. D has been good.
Jones. If he's behind the line, that's 3 free throws. It is.
TCU found Brandon Parrish.
Parrish is long and doesn't need to get that close to a small player to challenge the shot. He just got a little exuberant.
Washburn had a free throw to make it a 14-point TCU lead. He missed it. Bradley can't take advantage. Braves, both these teams have struggled from the line, shooting just over 60%.
That will lose you a lot of games, that number. Jones is one of those microwave guys, gets in the game, does a lot good, sometimes not so good. You got to use him sparingly. Omari Greer, the leading scorer on the team, has done nothing in this game so far. Been sitting over on the bench for quite a while. Average is nearly 15. So the absence of him from the scoring column is hurting their chances right now.
Warren Jones with a crazy early sample is the top bench scorer right now in the NBC. He gets 2 of 3. And what was a 13-point game is now 8.
A lot of inexperience on the floor right now for both teams.
Washburn doesn't use the clock. He doesn't need it.
Nice shot! Man, I thought that was going to break the rim. He shot it so hard. I'm impressed with Washburn. Does a lot of good stuff.
That ball finds him. Jones scrambling. It's going to be Barnes trying to beat the buzzer, and finally he gets one to go.
Rotation was a little late. Welcome to the game, Auston Barnes. They need your threes in the second.
Washburn. Washburn's got 8 points in this half. He's the leading player. High IQ guy. Xavier Taylor. You don't want to double me? I'll just hit this little jump hook. Very nicely done. And Barnes, right there from deep. He's got 7 points, and that was his only field goal. He's 4 free throws and a 3. Free throws, 12 for 21, 12 for 17. Not well done by either team. And the three-point shooting, pretty much non-existent for both teams.
Keep in mind, Bradley made their first two shots and their last two. That's how long the drought was in between. Chris Washburn's career high is 14, obviously more than halfway there, as both teams look for someone to score inside. Auston Barnes has created some good shots for himself, but hasn't been able to knock him down.
He's been able to get to the free throw line, 4 for 6. Number 5, Anderson, back in the game. An uncharacteristically poor stat line for him so far.
Keep in mind, TCU led this game by 13. The guy with the ball in his hands, Chris Washburn, had a free throw to make it 14. And this is the first time this year TCU couldn't get separation, but they are very hard to beat under Trent Johnson when they lead at the half. It's happened 24 times. 20 of the 24 they've gone on to win. Can't count on Keon Anderson to keep missing shots, too.
0 for 4.
And a rare turnover.
1 for 8 and 2 for 5, these two teams from outside the three-point arc. It's a big part of college basketball, and we're not seeing it here so far in this game.
TCU has been 47% coming in. Keon Anderson determined to get one to go. Can't.
Well, he started a turnover and a missed three in the start of the second half. Clearly, he is pressing, trying to do well. He is out of his comfort zone right now.
60% the first five. He's missed all 5 of his shots, all 3s in this one tonight. Greer still looking for that opening. He looks puzzled, trying to create a shot. He'll jump off to Jermaine Morgan, who's been very quiet. Barnes. Morgan, not always the guy you want with shot clock winding down. Barnes are going to clean it up and get fouled.
Interestingly enough, Greer and Anderson, the two leading scorers for both of these teams, not nearly what they're normally doing. Greer was really saddled in the first half as well. Those are the numbers on the season, 15.4. Tonight, only 2 for Anderson.
Now Trey Ziegler, his backcourt mate, has to come out, picking up a 3rd foul early in the second half.
Both of these coaches using lots of players in the first half. I think sometimes when you substitute freely like that, it destroys the rhythm of your offense.
Darryl Bell not in rhythm with Auston Barnes.
Boy, I'll say.
I was trying to paint a nicer picture.
Well, Bell's unhappy with Barnes. He thought Barnes should have been rolling. Barnes was popping.
Barnes was a hockey player in Michigan growing up. He didn't really switch to basketball until age 15, 16. Those are some big numbers. Bradley can't win at that pace. Ian Anderson tries to get in closer. That doesn't work. Price is right.
He's got 7.
Playing bigger minutes than he has in the first few games for TCU.
Right, and doing good things with those minutes.
There's what Keon Anderson does, and they're not going to catch him.
Well, when you're not getting it done offensively and you can't score, try to get it done defensively. Nice steal there. It was the anticipation that mattered.
It's the last thing you needed if your Bradley was to get him going after he missed his first 5.
There's the pick and pop.
Barnes the miss.
Pick and pop is only good when the guy who gets the pop can make the shot. And so far, we haven't seen that.
What you see is a team in white that hit the ground running. They were generally healthy to start the year. And they look, a couple of weeks ahead of Bradley. Still don't have their point guard. They turn it over on the offensive foul. Ian Anderson, defense to offense.
Anticipation. Bell was standing still, did not meet the pass, so that was an easy one.
That last foul was on Tavar Shepard, and we were really looking forward to seeing one of the better sophomores in the Big 12, but he has just been plagued by foul trouble. He'll take another seat. That's 3 fouls on Tavar Shepard. He's only played 8 minutes.
And Ziegler also, so 2 starters
on the pine. I'll tell you what, Washburn impresses defensively. Look at this.
There it is. You called that.
Man, he was guarding the ball, and then he's guarding everybody out there.
Cunningham gets the bounce.
Josh Cunningham.
18 years old. The biggest recruit who landed Bradley in over 30 years. Kean Anderson going to get the contact on Kadarryl Bell.
Bell's competitive, I tell you. He wants to play Anderson. Gino Ford said he's their best defensive player, and he drew the assignment, and so far, so good.
You're with us in the first half. You saw Amrick Fields there in the middle of your screen, number four for TCU. A very important player, high-skill player for TCU. And if he can stay healthy, he'll play significant minutes when they get into conference play. Parrish is good in the first half. Not so much here.
He's going to play significant minutes right now because of Shepard's foul trouble. So Fields going to get extended minutes right here. Makes them a little smaller, but makes them more skilled. He's a terrific passer.
Both these teams will play again tomorrow. It'll be interesting to see guys who play big minutes that don't normally have to come back. Big offensive rebound now. Josh Cunningham, the freshman, starting to feel the game around him, looking a lot more comfortable.
Well, right there, that's an example of not having Shepard in the game. Size matters close to the basket. That normally would be a Shepard rebound. Neither team did any work on the offensive glass in the first half.
Fields will try a three. Remember, nobody has taken TCU into the late rounds yet this year. How they perform in crunch time, there is no gauge yet because it hasn't happened. There hasn't been any crunch time. Cunningham will try a three. Both teams had shot that three well in the early part of the year, but not tonight.
Fields had his man pinned on the switch. He had a smaller player.
Kean Anderson.
Oh, he's thinking too much. Nice rebound.
One on three.
I'll tell you what. Anderson is thinking, thinking, thinking. And the more you think, the less you react. The steal. Anderson's getting two. Showing for them.
And combine high basketball IQ with a disposition to play defense. And you got a very dangerous young man right there.
Yeah. He looks young, facially young. Older brother plays at UTEP. This guy is going to be a big, big deal for TCU.
TCU led by 13. They had a free throw to go up by 14 late in the first half. They said nobody's really hung around yet. They got the lead back to 11 early in the second half. Again, Bradley playing defense as they have these last two games that they've had Auston Barnes. They're trying to give themselves a chance. Denrich Williams didn't play much in the first half. He'll come in and get Amrick Fields.
Yeah, now they're small, though. Kendrick Williams is small, only about 6'6". So if I'm Bradley, I'm going hard to the offensive glass here.
Price couldn't contain Barnes. Picks up the foul.
The good news is Price knew it, so he fouled early before the shot. So it's just an out-of-bounds play for Bradley. Wise play defensively when you beat foul early.
Barnes, big cut.
Yeah, Price got beat on two out-of-bounds plays right there in a row. Barnes should get close to the basket on him. He's got some size advantage. Right now, TCU is used to playing big. They got a small lineup out there right now.
What was 13 is now 6.
Nice ball fake.
Anderson to the line.
You know, a lot of guys just don't fake. They just go all the time. And if you are adept at faking with the ball or faking with your feet, you're going to get advantages. And Washburn does that beautifully. This is time right now in the game for this guy to take over the game because they're closing in. Bradley's closing in. He's their top guy. even though he's playing poorly in this game from a scoring standpoint, if he keeps his confidence, he can have a big impact down the stretch here.
Mountain West Rookie of the Year, 2012. Quiet leader is how they describe Kian Anderson. It doesn't matter if you're quiet or loud, as long as you lead. And you do it by knocking down free throws in the second half.
Yep, 92% on the year from the free throw line.
Last lead for the Braves was 4-2.
Boy, they are going to Barnes every time. He's getting touched.
That's why.
Yep. They need to get somebody bigger on Barnes because he's taking advantage of guys. Right here, they isolate him low on Williams. Williams just came in. Washburn jumped too soon on that. The great shot blockers jump after the offensive player goes in the air. Washburn, not a great shot blocker because he's not going to be one of those guys who's getting four a game or anything like that.
Second on Washburn with the foul starting to pile up, and a big three-point play for Auston Barnes.
Yep. He's the man right now. They will run something for him again. Set play. Christian Gore in the game for the first time.
Transfer from Brown.
Yeah. Highest SATs on the team, probably.
That's sort of a stereotype. Washburn just trying to create a rebound, and that's exactly what he did. He was not in good shooting position. You put it up on the rim, and you let Kenridge Williams go get it. Second on Cunningham.
Christian Gore did not play at all in the first half, and he comes in 13 minutes to go as the game is tightening. That's a very, very interesting substitution.
Kenridge Williams gets a very friendly bounce to keep it at six.
Let's keep an eye on Barnes. Let's see if they go to Auston, number four. He's been doing all the damage the last couple of minutes.
The team's well under 40% shooting.
They're looking
that way, yep. Yep.
They're trying to isolate him in the post.
Instead, Shaw has him slapped away. Bob, in the first half, Barnes got shots. He was creating shots. He just wasn't knocking them down. But clearly, Geno Ford saw something.
Yeah. Well, what he saw was smaller players are guarding him.
Warren Jones, how about that?
That's a 9 on the degree of difficulty scale. This guy loves every kind of shot in the book.
Gore stumbling. Offensive foul. And the momentum has turned here midway through the second half.
Well, Gore's going to go out, and you can see the look on Trent Johnson's face. He's got to be wondering right now. Good position, feet outside of the arc. The help side defender has to be there. There are going to be more charges this year. They changed the rule last year where he could hardly get a charge in the game. Change it back to the old way now.
That wasn't on the SATs. Shaw driving and scoring, and all of a sudden, from down 13, Bradley has cut it to two.
I think TCU needs a timeout right here. You know, Trent's probably going to let them play through it. I would call timeout, settle them down confidence-wise.
The first adversity TCU has faced this year. Parrish stops the bleeding.
Nice response. That's the first clean look for Parrish in the game. He's been struggling with guys on him, taking contested shots.
Barnes wants it. Barnes against Parrish. Game turned a little bit when Cunningham had those two buckets in a row, but he's gone for the offensive foul.
Nice D. Bradley making a move. The reason they can go to him is because TCU is playing small. Shepard has three fouls and is on the bench, and he is taking advantage of his matchup. 6'8", 215. Got some length.
Bradley has made more shots in the second half than they did in the first 20 minutes combined. TCU has gone cold. One field goal in the last 6 minutes.
2 point guards in the game at the same time.
Which way? Bradley ball. They're winning the 50-50 plays now.
Collins and Anderson in for TCU at the same time. Very good hustle right here by Omari Greer. Has not been a factor offensively, but right there showing his grit. 3-guard lineup right here. Greer in, Bell and Jones all together.
The hot hand does it again, and Bradley's within two.
Makes you wonder what would have happened had he been eligible and ready to play in the first 2 games, which they lost.
14 now for Barnes. This was a 13-point TCU lead. Parrish on the move.
Washburn has not been out in the second half at all. You got to wonder if his legs are feeling a little bit.
Trent Johnson wanted to see what would happen when his team finally got tested, and that test is upon them. They'll get it back. Mike Shaw called in the paint.
Yeah, he was being fronted by Washburn, and he extended his elbow. You can hold your elbows up, but once you extend them, it's going to be an automatic foul. Take a look. Lower right-hand corner of your screen. He steps in, extends his arms, and gives Washburn a shot. Can't do it.
Three on Shaw in just 12 minutes.
Nice matchup right here with the two number fours. Barnes is going to be guarding Fields.
Ian Anderson still trying. 0-for-7 from distance.
Whoa.
And yet TCU has the lead. That's their look at it right now.
Exactly. If you would have told me he was 0-for-7 and they had the lead, I would have said no way. He's such a big part of their team last year, but they're better this year.
Fields got tripped up. They won't call it instead. It's going to be a turnover. Charged to Anderson, and Bradley will have another chance to tie.
Shepard's back in the game now for Trent Johnson. Nobody tripped him on purpose. He just fell on somebody's leg. Right here. This is just him falling. No foul. Significantly, though, Shepard is back in the game. Number 14. He's the biggest guy on the team, and he can rebound. He is guarding Barnes. Now, whether he can guard him out here, I wonder. But close to the basket, he'll be much more effective than what they've had.
Bell the kick out. Jones for three, and Bradley has the lead.
You talk about confidence. Jones is confident.
18-6 is the Bradley run.
No fast break baskets. No easy. Nothing easy. You got to play 5-on-5 from the 3-point line and in. You're in trouble in this era of college basketball.
Anderson, the good look to Ziegler. Not even close. Bradley made 5 shots the entire first half. They've now made 6 in a row.
I like the 3-guard lineup. It's been good with Jones and Greer and Bell.
Yep, Jones traveled. He's skidding along the floor.
Jones might lead the NCAA in shots per minute this year because he is looking to score when he has it. He and Greer right there next to one another. Small lineup in the game. You know, Ford was a small player who was a great, great scorer.
He has finished ahead of a pretty good player in Ohio for his high school career. Contact on the drive. And what's interesting about this, Coach, is Geno Ford's club has played in close games. You know, they're 2-2. They were considered the underdog here this weekend, but they've had these crunch time minutes. They've gone through them already. TCU has.
Yeah, a little experience.
Who is that guy that he's ahead of? Oh.
Look at number four.
34 points better than the other guy.
That is high school points for a career. So Geno Ford, I saw him play in the AAUs, and, I mean, he was a dynamic scorer, kind of a Steve Nash-type guy.
They never burned his jersey.
Well, if you're TCU, this is the way to do it. Score from the free throw line when you're not getting field goals. That should be the mantra. Take it at the basket.
Kenrich Williams puts TCU back in front. And who knew we were next to that man?
Well, Shepard's been in foul trouble, no doubt about it. And when he's in the game, that changes dramatically the interior defense because he's the biggest guy, he's broad, knows how to play in the paint, knows how to defend in there. And when he was on the bench, that's when Bradley made their run with Barnes getting shots close to the basket.
Auston Barnes takes a rest. He's the hot hand. He got Bradley back in this game. He and Warren Jones.
Taylor and Cunningham are the bigs right now for Bradley. They're still using the three-guard lineup.
That's a play that will not show up in the box score but could be very big in this game. Washburn turning Bradley over. Hasn't scored in the second half, but still competing on defense.
Hustle on the sidelines. They want to win this game.
On CBS Sports, this game has been a lot more fun to watch than maybe we thought it was going to be. And Chris Washburn is growing up in front of our eyes.
Yeah, he's really been a very, very solid player at both ends of the floor in this game, scoring, defending. We saw a great defensive play. He can guard the perimeter and he can guard the paint. He's been excellent in this game. Auston Barnes has checked back in for Bradley. He did most of the damage when they made their run. Number four, missed the first two games, they lost. He's been in the next two games, they won.
What changed for Bradley here in the second half?
They got quality shots in the second half, and some foul trouble for TCU took some players out of the game, which that also helped.
Taylor too aggressive with Washburn.
Yeah, well, they're going to try to pressure him. There's no doubt about that. And he's able to put the ball on the floor.
His dad, the third pick in the draft in 1986.
North Carolina State.
Yep, he was a phenomenal college player.
He was bigger than his son, way bigger. 6'11", 275 maybe. Let's take a look at his form on the free throw line. He puts his whole hand on the ball, which is not the prescribed manner. You usually want to have some room between your palm and the basketball.
Why?
Well, it makes it, if you put your palm on the ball as well, you're going to get some left to right movement on the ball. It doesn't, it's not as soft that way. But sometimes you go long. Also.
Like you off the tee. Same idea.
He's only 44%, right, from free throw line. So we got to do something to try to help him.
Well, 9 of 20 on the year. This game is going the way every TCU game has gone this year until those later stages of the first half.
Look at that defensive stance by Washburn. Anderson's got to get involved right now. You know, he's letting Bell go wherever he wants.
Like there. Big offensive rebound put back for Jermaine Morgan. He's been quiet. That's a big bucket to tie.
Well, you got to blame Anderson for that because he did not go over the screen or under it. He got trailed, and his man had to pick up a clear bath for Morgan to the offensive glass.
Braves have not rebounded well in their first four games of the year, but they're out-rebounding TCU. Kian Anderson still can't get one to go. But they'll get it back.
Credit. The hustle right there by TCU. Take a look as this shot comes off. I mean, everybody's hustling right there. Barnes laughing.
He is happy to be back on the court. Ian Anderson, one of the hotter three-point shooters in college basketball to begin the year, is 0 for 8 from distance in this game.
Yeah, Williams made that play last time. Now he's back in the game right here, number 34.
Take it to it!
Ziegler's been on the bench for a long time. And now he is back in.
Anderson on the attack. Shepard. And Morgan the rebound.
Boy, that was a clean look. He was wide open. Notice how all the red shirts collapse when Anderson takes it to the paint. Bell's giving you the fist play right here.
That was Shepard's first shot of this game.
Wow.
Darrell Bell, he's been strong from the opening bell. Jones, boy, he thought he got hit. The Bradley bench thought he got hit.
No fast break points in the game except for the one steal that Anderson had for TCU.
It led to his only bucket.
Yep. And when you're not getting fast break points, you got to get it on the offensive glass.
That's it. Big poop for Kenrich Williams, and who found him? Washburn did.
Indeed. Indeed. Nice cut also. That was a three-man play with the three bigs. Shepard made the screen.
Really like how these bigs play together.
Notice the D right here by Shepard. Very nicely done. They missed that when he was on the bench. For a big guy, he can move his feet laterally pretty well. Williams moving without the basketball. He gets a back screen, slides in.
A little jump hook in the lane.
Nice legs underneath you. Get that elevation.
Look at those numbers.
Yeah, that's disheartening. 1 for 10. I don't think he's had a game like that.
It's going to be forgotten quickly if TCU goes to 6-0. Shepard fouled by Cunningham. This is the test that Trent Johnson wanted for TCU, and it's the effort that Geno Ford has been waiting to see from Bradley.
Yeah, good point. Very good point. It's a good game for both of these teams. Shepard's a 64% free throw shooter on the year. He's a leading rebounder on this team. Shaw comes in to give them a little bit more muscle. Leading rebounder, nearly 9 points a game. This kid's got a bright future. Let's watch his follow-through on his free throw. He did it beautifully right there. Lots of times, guys short arm. As soon as the ball leaves their hand, they think the shot's done. Right hand stays up after the ball leaves your hand. Nice follow-through. That was beautiful.
Played some of his best games in the Big 12 tournament last year, which was telling as a freshman.
Yeah. Let's see his defensive movement here. Nice help here. Here's how he digs on Barnes.
He gets a second chance.
What a difference Shepard is making in this game.
Yes.
And he and Washburn are in together. And Williams also. That's a strong front line. Ziegler, take it to the basket, guy. Not an outside shooter. They want Washburn at the top of the key so he can see the entire floor and make plays.
Anderson the reset. This has the feel of a big possession. That's one.
Nice call, my friend. 1 for 3 on the year from threes coming into this game. And he knocks one in clutch. Yeah, and foul trouble. Josh Cunningham was sitting right there. Let's keep an eye on Washburn and Barnes. They are matched up against one another here. Washburn is going to be guarding Barnes, who's been the guy who has really helped Bradley in the second half. Shepard will be guarding the paint. There is Barnes. Been excellent in the second half. As we've enumerated, he missed the first two games of the year, which they lost. He's played in the next two, which they won.
Game high 14. Greer saves Jones, and then he turns it over.
Wow. Fortunate. Really fortunate. Execution required. Late in the game, when you have the lead, you got to get a quality shot or get fouled. That's the objective.
Jones the defense on Ziegler. He turns it over. 5 seconds.
Ziegler got infatuated with the bounce right there. Bradley's doing a good job on the screen on the ball. They are coming out. The big men are hedging, and if they have to, they switch and move laterally. TCU not getting anything out of the ball screen in this game.
Trent Johnson wanted to see what would happen if the team punched him in the mouth. Geno Ford's team has done just that in the second half.
I think they got Shepard on this.
They did. That's his fourth. Roll the dice.
Well, I would, but Trent Johnson's not. And he's coming in with an experienced player that's helped him offensively. Fields is coming in. 34. He's played a good game. I mean, a four. He's played a good game. Williams, 34, has to do a job on Jones, too, because Jones is going to let it fly if he gets it.
Washburn stays in front of Barnes.
Nicely. Good call. That's the matchup.
Barnes trying to get free. Got Ziegler on the switch, but it's going to be Bell.
Shot clock.
Fortunate bounce, and Barnes, big three.
Get out of here! Are you kidding me? Oh, my goodness. That was deep.
17 for Barnes, and Bradley lives.
You gotta love it, man. Kids want to win.
With Shepard out, TCU was vulnerable at the defensive end on the glass. Can Anderson come up big, even though he's played a poor game? We'll see.
Ziegler with the shot clock winding down. Morgan, a big rebound.
Solid D by Bradley. They deserve that possession.
Bradley has taken some huge strides in their season over the last hour. But an offensive foul called on Morgan is going to give it back to TCU.
You know, sometimes it's a screener's fault, but sometimes it's the guy with the ball goes too soon before the screener can get there. So you can't blame Morgan necessarily on that play.
And now Morgan, Taylor, and Cunningham with four for Bradley.
Yeah, at this juncture, you don't worry about it, right? A minute and 48 to go. I would get Shepard back in if I was Trent Johnson.
They will have to find a way to win games when Kean Anderson doesn't make shots, and they're a minute 48 from doing that here tonight and playing for a championship tomorrow. And if they do, that's the reason why. Chris Washburn.
Yep, no doubt about it. He's played a great game. Clearly the best player in the game for TCU in this one. First year player for them. He's going to make a difference.
Fields makes the extra pass. Kenrich Williams will finish.
Yeah, he's done some good things in the second half, moving without it, right?
Kenrich Williams has seven in the last 5 minutes.
Yep. All off moving without the ball. Had the three, said the heck with that.
They go back to Barnes with good reason. When the well has been dry, Barnes has kept it moving.
Kenrich Williams, this was a pick and pop, and they got caught in rotation. Rotation was a little too late. He ball fakes and drives. And a nice little dunk close to the basket. Nice execution by TCU there.
Kenrich Williams is the guy that went to Trent Johnson and said, hey, anything you need me to do, coach? Well, tonight, he said, we need you to be our go-to guy in the final minutes. Barnes has been good.
Barnes did a good job of moving without the ball also. He's not a real post-up guy because of his thin body weight, but he moves well without it. Williams really doing a terrific job, as you've enumerated.
Happy to come off the bench. A crowded front court for TCU. Barnes has 19.
Well, they got to make something happen. Brown's got to make something happen right here with the defense. Trap, go after it. If you foul, you foul.
Trent Johnson will call the timeout. Pretty much all of that damage.
And he didn't do it on his own, you know. I mean, he got a pick from Shepard for a little play. He was the beneficiary of a nice executed rotation play. And, you know, you have to have a guy that can play like that, that he doesn't need the ball to score. 10 points in the second half is a mistake. They had an opportunity to trap on the sideline. They should.
Ian Anderson going to bleed that clock dry. Too much on that pass for Washburn, and that is costly, not just for the turnover, but the fact they took so little time off that clock.
Yeah, there was 18 seconds left on the clock when he made the play. Washburn was wide open. Try to stay positive, coach. That's it. Can't worry about the last play in a game like this. Just worry about what's right in front of you.
Series of teachable moments. Bell the miss. Cunningham blocked by Washburn. Barnes will save it. Jones for three. A prayer unanswered. Shepard comes up with a big rebound, and the shot clock is off.
Wow, what a series of plays right there. You got a foul here.
Yeah, he didn't realize it. Took Cadero Bell for about 3 or 4 seconds with the bench screaming out that the shot clock was off. And now TCU will have to hit their free throws. 26 seconds from 6-0.
Man, we had action on the glass on that last play, and it's a good thing Shepard was in there. He's the one who came up with the ball. Anderson has had trouble, you know, because of his offense. Let's take a look at the other end. Look at this scrum. Everybody in the paint. Shepard comes up with it. He gets trapped and still comes up with it. That's a beautiful play. Anderson has been caught on high screens, and he's put his teammates at a disadvantage because when the screen is really high, he can go under. He's got quick, so he can go under. When it's at the three-point line, he's got to fight. They've got to hedge a little bit. But he has not shown determination on that play in this game.
These are the little things that get exposed when you take the step up in class.
Yeah. Well, he hasn't made them from outside, but he's been nothing but money at the free throw line. So he went under that time. But he's his man. Going all the way.
Bell misses in close, and that should do it. Barnes is waiting for three on the wing, but Cadero Bell figured he had an easy two, and it looked like he did. This is a big step forward for Bradley when you consider the level of competition in their first four games. They have 1-2 in a row. You can make a case that this has been their best performance for Geno Ford, even though it's not going to go their way.
Missouri Valley Conference. Bradley has a proud tradition. And they didn't have a good year last year, and I think things are going to be positive this season. Of course, Wichita State has dominated that conference the last couple of years, and they're going to do it again this year. Fred Van Vliet and company.
Bradley just has to stay east. They go west to the Mississippi River. This will be their 28th consecutive loss. Jones misses the three. It's in the hands of Trey Ziegler. It wasn't easy. It certainly wasn't pretty. But TCU will get to the championship game at 6.